Bridge rectifiers. If you're powering a treadmill motor, which is more often than not a DC motor, with a variable transformer or an SCR voltage controller, you have got to have a way to convert AC current into DC current. And that's what a bridge rectifier does.
Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video.
You would think that bridge rectifiers would be pretty simple, but I've actually gotten quite a few questions lately asking specifically about bridge rectifiers. I have talked about them in lots of my videos, but I've never gone through and given a real in-depth view of how it works, what it does, and how you hook it up. So that's what we're going to do here today. Now, the first thing that I want to go over is not all bridge rectifiers are created equally. This guy right here, you see it appear in a lot of my videos. And the reason for that is the size of the terminals. It is super easy to hook up. This particular one is rated at 50 amps and is good, I think, up to 1,000 volts. So you would think that this would be sufficient. This is the one that so many people on YouTube are recommending. They're like, get this, it only costs a few bucks and you're good to go. The problem is these are prone to failure. Yes, it's rated at 50 amps, but max amperage does not translate directly to running amperage. If we are running this at 25 amps, we're probably going to be okay. If the system gets incredibly loaded and something spikes, we still run the risk of burning this out. In fact, I've burned out several of these, so I do not recommend running them for powering your treadmill motor. Even though the amperage is enough, even though the voltage is enough, you're asking for trouble. Now this guy, it's rated at 100 amps and is good for 1200 volts. And I have yet to burn one of these out. This is the type of rectifier that I am using on my lathe, on my mill, on my bandsaw, and they work extremely well. If you're gonna run a rectifier, it's gonna get hot. So it is important that you have a heat sink. Now this was removed from a defunct MC2100 board. I just cut out this section. And these fins, they help with the cooling. So heat transfers into the aluminum. The aluminum is touching more air because of the fins, and that helps keep it cool. This guy comes with his own fins, so no heat sink is required when using that one. That's an advantage right there. With either of these, if you're going to use a bridge rectifier, as far as I'm concerned, you must use one of those. There's lots of ways to accomplish this. You can do it with a fuse. You can do it with a circuit breaker like this. You can do it with the push button style circuit breaker that you see in a lot of my videos. The reason this is so critical is when a bridge rectifier fails, oftentimes you get a direct short between the terminals, which means you've got the full voltage coming out of your power supply and it is immediately shorted back into the power supply. And if you don't have something that will trip in a situation like that, you will burn up the power supply. I've had comments on my channel, people saying, yep, didn't have a fuse, I stuck a blade or overloaded the system, burned up the rectifier, and it ended up tearing out my power supply. And it'll happen immediately. The power supply will make a loud bang and you're just done. So between your power supply and your rectifier, you must use a circuit breaker type setup. So we know what it does. It converts AC current into DC current. But the question is, how does it do that? What magic is used here? Well, we paid a lot of money to get a graphic. What do you mean we don't have the graphic? You mean I don't get paid for making videos on YouTube? Okay, maybe I make a little bit on advertising, but not enough to cover a graphic? Okay, well, we don't have a budget for graphics. So what we're going to use is chopsticks. All right, so let's use our chopsticks. And we will show you how this all works. Now, before I place this last chopstick, I want to tell you why I'm using chopsticks. Chopstick represents a diode, and a diode is a device that only allows electricity to flow one direction. We're going to use the arrow shape of the chopstick to show directionality. The arrow's pointing that way, so electricity will only flow that way. If this was a diode, and we hooked positive up here and negative up here, electricity would flow through it. But if we hook the positive terminal up here and the negative terminal up here, there would be no flow of electricity. So that's how a diode works. Now, if you take four of them and you put them in this square pattern, just like I have right here, we now have a bridge rectifier made of chopsticks. And that's our negative. And that's our positive. Wow. Chopsticks and masking tape. The budget of this channel is amazing. All right, so here's how this works. This is AC current coming in. This is AC current coming in. Now, if you're not aware, the difference between AC and DC current is this. DC current means direct current. Electricity always flows in one direction. So positive goes out, the electrons come back in on the negative. AC stands for alternating current. The way that works is you have two wires, your hot and your neutral, and they flip-flop 60 times a second between positive and negative. So let's say this is the positive, this is the negative, 60 times a second, back and forth, back and forth. So when we hook our AC up, it does not matter if this is the hot and this is the neutral, or if this is the hot and this is the neutral. And the reason it does not matter is because it's going to be flip-flopping. When this one's positive, electricity flows here. When this one's positive, electricity flows here. When this one is negative, the current flows that direction. When this one is negative, the current coming out of our device flows there. And that's all there is to it. That's how four diodes create a way to convert AC current into DC current. So the last question I get is, how do I wire them up? Well, they're not all the same. You cannot assume that the way this one wires up is the way that this one wires up. If we look at this guy, there is a positive and that is your AC terminal. Now I know for this style that the opposites are kitty corner. This is AC and this one is AC. Now, it does not matter when you hook it up which one is hot and which one is common, because it's AC and it's going to be flip-flopping back and forth. Either the black here or your black here, and then white here or white here. Then on this, we have the positive here and the negative here. And those are going to be the two terminals that go to your motor. So positive current there, negative current there. Obviously, we need to run it through this. Now, the reason you see this often in my videos is because it's super easy to hook up. I can take a wire connector and just plug it in. This allows me to easily change things up and easily set things up. And oftentimes when I'm shooting a video with one of these, I'm not loading the system. I'm just demonstrating basic things. So I'm not too worried about burning it up. I still use the circuit breaker. Now, on this guy, it's set up just a little bit different. These two terminals are your AC terminals. And you can tell that by the little squiggly line right next to the terminals. These top two terminals are your positive and your negative. This one has a plus down by the base of the terminal, and this one has a negative down by the base of the terminal. This is your positive terminal, that's your negative terminal. Now, with this smaller one, and again, this is the reason I use it for all the bench tests, you can easily take a connector and just plug it right in. But with this bigger one, it's too big, it won't fit. And people ask me, how do you end up doing that? Well, all I do is I solder 16 gauge or heavier wire, depending on what kind of a power supply I'm building. 16 is the minimum, 14 or 12 gauge would be even better. I solder the wires to each individual terminal, and then I cover the entire terminal with heat shrink tubing. And what I end up with is a really nice setup. And then on the end of the pigtail, I can put a connector and be able to use it. So that's really all there is to it. If you're going to use a variable transformer or you're going to use an SCR voltage controller, you must run a bridge rectifier. If you're going to run a bridge rectifier, you must run a circuit breaker. And if you're going to mess with doing all this, spend the money. This was only like $12 or $14. I have this linked down in the description. Yes, you can get 10 of these for $5 or $10, but do you really need 10 of them? You probably only need one or two. And they're going to burn up. They're probably going to burn up your power supply if you're not using a circuit breaker. So just get the good one. It's not that expensive. It works extremely well, and you will be happy with it.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.